Welcome to JMJ Automation. Here we're using VTScadaLIGHT for a smaller water system. One thing that VTScadaLIGHT has allowed us to do is reach out to smaller customers who without it would not be able to afford SCADA at all. In this example, we have a single well and a single tank, and it's supplying water to about 400 customers. We're using the SEL, Schweitzer Engineering Laboratories, pump automation controller as the PLC. And this controller is awesome because it comes pre-configured, and it's a plug and play device that allows you to put it in a pump up situation as if you're filling up a well for water or emptying a wet well in a wastewater application. In this application, we're using it in the pump up situation, and in tank mode you have set points, so you can set the set points to whatever cut on and cut off levels you want. You can alarm on high level alarm, low level alarm. In timer mode, you can tell what time you want it to turn off and what time you want it to turn off. In switch mode, that's a local mode where they have like a Mercoid switch, pressure switch local, and they can put it in switch mode. They can see if it's calling for water, make sure the booster pump's running, because we all know that you don't want to pump unchlorinated water into a water system. And you see the motor running also. We're also able to set alarms on all of these. And they're also able to get important data like motor runtime today and yesterday, cycles today and cycles yesterday. You know, whenever you're working with a larger electric motor, you don't want it starting, especially if it's a cross the line start motor, you don't want it starting and stopping too many times in one day. So the operator is actually able to keep up with this and see it in real time. One person asked me, why would a smaller water system or a smaller wastewater system need SCADA? Well, here's an example. Here with the JAT water system, they don't have anybody on staff 24/7. They have an operator that they pay basically as a freelancer to go and check the system per state requirements, go and check the system once a day. So this person goes and checks the well and checks the tank one time a day. Well, so each day they just get to see if there's a problem at that very moment. So for the next 24 hours, what happens if there's a problem? Or over a period of time, thanks to the built-in data logger historian that VTScadaLIGHT offers, they're able to get alarms right away. They're also able to see historical data. Is the pump running more right now than it has been in the past? And that's a big benefit to a small system, especially one that's not fully staffed, that they don't get to check it every single day. Anyway, I hope this helps y'all out. Thank you very much.